Can you tell us a little bit about your character and where she fits into this extraordinary story?
Yeah, she is a member of LGSM. She's originally the first girl to be in LGSM, which I think she's quite proud of. And then we get some other ladies coming in a little later on. And she's just part of this group who believes that, you know, what's happening to these minors is wrong, that we need to do something about it. And she's quite feisty and she's not afraid to tell people when they're being an idiot. And yeah, she's a lot of fun to play, yeah. It's really important. This film is about community and about communities looking after each other. It's about human beings caring about other human beings. And that, you know, at the moment in this world, there's a lot of bad stuff going on. And, you know, this film for me is about let's get back up and be active in our activism and let's not hide behind our phones and sort of social media, which I'm not saying is a wonderful thing, social media, but let's do something, let's get up and the word is activism, let's be active with it. And I think that's what's relevant to this current time that we're in now, yeah.
So you're working with a fantastic cast, people like Andrew Scott, obviously well-known as Sherlock fans. Can you talk a bit about your experiences working with your co-stars?
Yeah, I mean, it was terrifying because, you know, I've watched Andrew and Bill and Imelda and Paddy. I mean, I've watched them all do their thing over the years. And so sitting in a read-through room on the first day when you read the script, sitting next to Andrew Scott and not being able to really say hello because you're so kind of starstruck was quite difficult, but in the end, you know, we were work colleagues and we were making something so overwhelmingly special that all that goes away and it was just about work and mucking in and doing the job and honouring these wonderful people that we're portraying tonight, you know. So that's what it was like. They're wonderful human beings and a lot of fun to be around, but yeah. The whole film, Stephen is such an amazing writer that it would be hard for me to say any scene was a favourite. I mean, Dominic West doing his thing, I won't spoil it, but him doing his thing was a special, you know, I think it was 2 days to shoot that and it was just wonderful. But then there are much, much more tender moments, things what Andrew Scott does where you go, oh, okay. You know, there's a lot of wonderful scenes, so I don't have a favourite, I love it all, you know. I've got an E4 show coming out called Glue, written by Jack Thorne. And that comes out this coming month. So that's cool. And other stuff coming up, but I can't say. But yeah, it's all good.
Can you tell us anything about Glue?
Glue, I can't say too much. Again, it's a murder mystery. And it's been wonderfully written. And I think people are going to be quite shocked at the style of it. I don't think we've seen anything like Glue yet. So I'm quite excited to see the response, yeah. Why they should be watching this film? Because if they're human beings who believe in other human beings and who believe that people should be treated fairly and right and that you should be able to be who you want to be when you want to be it, then this is a film. This is a film, yeah.